Ricard, let's talk about Bill C-18, and I guess maybe we can say versus big tech. Where does it stand right now? What's the latest?
Well, the latest, as you may have seen in the media and your own platform and other platforms, is that the Online News Act has passed by regulation, by law. Now, big tech, the search engines, the social media that we are used to look at for our own personal news, our group of friends, and these are now not these are going to have to pay for setting up links to news outlets, the links as to their content. And the initial reaction is that many of these big tech companies have said that when the time comes and the Online News Act goes in motion, they will stop linking. They will stop setting up links to those news outlets. And the latest news is that some of them are more eager, or they're less patient than others. And Meta, for example, just went ahead and said, "You know what? We're just going to stop. We're just going to stop right now." And so that has created a stir of public opinion involving the federal government, involving a bunch of other stakeholders, that is sort of billifying, if I may use that name, if I use that verb, the big tech for that reaction.
Let's talk about the approach that the Canadian government has taken to this. Curious to get your insight on, did they go about this the right way? Was this a collaborative process with Google, with Meta? How do you interpret all of this?
Yeah, so I personally don't think they went the right way, but I want to be very direct in saying that this is not the Canadian government is not the first government that in my opinion gets the conversation wrong, in that the message that is being put out there is that, oh, look, revenues in advertising has been going down for a number of years in traditional media. At the same time, search engines and other big tech has seen its revenues go up. So it's gotta be that those guys are the ones that are sort of like stealing away the revenues that we see decrease in traditional media. And moreover, the big tech has been, you can go to some search engines and search for news, and so you get some curation of what news are out there about the topic that you are interested in. And so all that together has come to say, well, we know that media is necessary for the well-functioning of democracies. And if media is going to die because there's no advertising revenues, we should actually get somebody to pay for those lack of revenues. And, it's one of those things where the smoking gun basically is claimed to be in the hands of big tech, and so that's where it is. Like the reality, and this is kind of like going back to your question, is that every single piece of evidence, and I'm not talking about anecdotal evidence. I'm talking about pure research evidence with the most advanced statistical methods, basically show that actually media benefits from the search engines, from the Metas, from the X's, because they receive extra visits to their outlets. So they attract news consumers that otherwise would have not end up there. And that means additional revenues. So the conversation should have been, hey, there's a loop effect that is benefiting both of them. Is benefiting, obviously the big tech is benefiting from the fact that there's all this new content involved in there, that people go and search for this new content. The traditional media is benefiting from the fact that these guys are the vast amount of content that we have out there nowadays, and there's a formula hidden out there. It's going to be a win-win situation where all tables come in with you know, nobody pointing fingers at anybody, and sort of thinking about what is the long run problem that we're facing. And the long run problem we're facing is that we don't want a less diverse media. We want plurality of opinions. We want plurality of views of point. And in order to have that in the long run, in the short term, in the near future, we need to secure financing for those media that actually generate and create content. So, and I think that's what happened. Like, I think the Canadian government didn't go about this way. From the very beginning, big tech has been accused of basically stealing money. And that's not true. There's literally no evidence whatsoever that basically says that that the traditional media is not benefiting from the existence of big tech. And so I think that should have been in the get-go, in the first conversations when this whole thing started.
A lot to unpack there. Let's just go back a little bit, because you had mentioned a few countries around the world that have pursued something like this. Maybe we can kind of work our way backwards. In 2021, it was Australia with their law. In 2019, we saw the link tax, part of the EU, of course. Who has gotten it right? What can we learn from them, and what can we incorporate?
Well, I don't know that anybody has gotten it right to begin with. The EU and Google, in this case, have had a love-hate relationship for many years now. So it all, if you think of the first Google News outlet that was set up out there, this goes back to 2002, and immediately 3-4 years later, Belgium already said, hey, this is not working for us. From that point on, it was France, it was Germany, it was Spain. And at some point, in the case of Spain in particular, Google basically said, you know what, we're going to shut it down. There's no Google News in Spain, basically. And so from that point on, Google has been harder on this. Prior to those moments, Google had actually sat down and said, well, you know, maybe the problem is that the current news outlets, they're just not very good at navigating this new digital world that we live in. So they set up training funds for like newspapers to sort of renovate, to renew their online outlets to be better at attracting traffic. And eventually, that with the first time that there was a very clear financing urgency was in the case of Spain, when Google decided to shut that down. In the case of Australia, I think in terms of what the law looks like there, it's very similar to what it looked like in Spain. It's very similar to what we are having here. And it is fine to say there's also very well done research that shows that the minute that law went into place, and if you wanted to look for news in Google Australia, you were getting links from New Zealand outlets and American outlets talking about what's happening in Australia, right? So we know that the minute that you ask Google or Meta or X to actually pay for these things, they're going to look for substitutes that they don't have to pay for, right? That we know.
Let's talk about blocked content. In the case of, we've been seeing how important content is, especially given times of emergency, given wildfires. How has Google and Meta responded to these requests to make the content available?
Well, you know, from the side of Google and Meta, my understanding is that, and I could be wrong about this, Larissa. So, my understanding is that Google has not blocked the fire emergency just yet. my understanding is that Meta has. Basically, and my understanding of how this works or how this is going to work is that they're blocking all the news that come out of news outlets. So, for example, if the government comes up with a website that basically contains all the information in there, that link does not belong to a news outlet, and therefore it shouldn't be blocked. That's sort of my understanding. And you know, the way that these guys are seeing this, especially Meta in this case, is that they don't differentiate on whether this is an emergency or not. It's like, okay, so you're asking me to pay for links that are gonna take traffic to news outlets. I said that I'm not gonna do this, and they're just not doing it, right? I was talking to another journalist about this earlier today, and so, you know, Meta, the old Facebook, still has that tool that in case of emergency, in case of a natural disaster, you can actually say it there, like, hey, I am safe at this location, right? And I'm pretty sure that that's still happening. So it's not that Meta is not that Meta is blocking that. It's not that Meta is not actually allowing for news. It's just that they're blocking the actual links to news outlets, right? And so that doesn't imply government links. It doesn't imply, you know, health department links. It doesn't apply. You see where I'm going with this? So we need to be very careful about what's being blocked and what's not being blocked.
Lastly, just before we let you go, the Online News Act goes into effect in Canada the end of the year. What would you like to see? Is there anything that we can do going forward? What would you like to see?
I like, and obviously, Larysa, you're asking me for a personal opinion here, right? So I don't have a crystal ball for what I think is going to happen, but this is what I would like to see. I think that especially with this national emergency that we're living right now, we have seen that there's a lot of social value of having this social media and these search engines to spread information when we really need it, right? We saw this as well during COVID, right? When there were an infection of news of all sorts. And so we would try to look for what kind of news are we're. And so I hope that this event is an event that sort of like brings stakeholders to the table and say, okay, there's actually a lot of value to this. So let's try to think about a compensation scheme, if any, that actually benefits both big tech for distributing knowledge and distributing news out there to people that perhaps don't have a preferred outlet that they actually go to, and also try to help the financial conditions that some of these news outlets are in, right? So one of the things, and with this I'll conclude, also very early in this year, I think that Google came to terms with French news outlets for a one-to-one compensation that would acknowledge the contribution that these news outlets are doing to Google News. This was not a per link payment, but this was an overall compensation, right? So here the French government, I believe that actually allowed for each outlet to sort of sit down with Google and have an honest conversation about what are the benefits and cons of linking their content in there. And so it seems like that's going to solve the problem in France. So maybe we need to look at that and sort of like try to, before the end of the year, to sort of like come out to the table and think about, okay, who is benefiting from this? The Canadian people. You know, what can we do, both the traditional media and the big tech, to actually increase what matters, value for everybody, and look for a win-win solution?